hair fall after 6 months of a hair transplant. I did my hair transplant 6 months ago in India. The hair growth till now was good, and I still see some new hairs are growing. But along with the new hairs growing, I'm having a very high rate of hair fall from the transplanted area. This is the first time I'm having such hair fall post-surgery. I consulted my surgeon, and he suggested to have biotin capsules along with finasteride tablets and 5% minoxidil. I would like to know if this is a normal or serious issue.
Thank you for your question. It has now been several months since your transplant, and you're noticing a fair amount of hair falling out despite having had the transplant. Now, your physician did prescribe for you a combination of biotin, finasteride, and minoxidil. So essentially, your physician is trying to restore hair that is actively thinning. So let's understand exactly what's been going on. First of all, the procedure of hair transplantation, where hair is being placed in between existing hair, can cause a situation called shock loss, where a combination of swelling and trauma can put hairs in an advanced stage of called the telogen phase, where essentially the hair follicles are no longer the active growing phase and actually get shocked. When they shock, they fall out, and after several months they start to regrow. The other thing to be mindful of, and it's not likely necessarily to be the case, because with the addition of finasteride and minoxidil, essentially your doctor is thinking about managing your natural progression of hair loss. That means that, of course, even with a transplant, male pattern hair loss, or female pattern hair loss for that matter, will still continue. We're talking about genetically susceptible hairs continuing to fall out. Now, the degree of fallout that you've had would be unusual for progression in such a short period. So I think there may be more of a shock loss aspect to your situation, but it is certainly reasonable to add medical therapy to help bring back your hairs a little bit faster. Something to learn about that we have been in a leadership position in is the use of a material called extracellular matrix combined with platelet-rich plasma that we are doing to help treat both male and female pattern hair loss in our practice. And this material has helped a lot of our patients who come to us from around the world not only treat the progression of hair loss, but reverse the hair thinning. So what many of our patients do who come to us with hair thinning, before even undergoing a transplant, will do this injection treatment and see how much of their hair actually comes back and thickens. It is very gratifying to be able to see people who are progressing, particularly younger people, younger males who are in their 20s and 30s and progressively losing hair over the course of a few years, suddenly stop and reverse to the point where a significant amount of their hair that looked like it was gone comes back. Now, routinely what we'll then do is then say to our patients about a year afterwards, are you satisfied or do you want to have more hair? And when they say they want more, in cases where they say they want to have more hair, we offer the option of transplantation. And during that time when we do transplantation, we use this material, this extracellular matrix, for advanced healing for the donor area, so that after I do the harvesting of the strip and the closure, I also apply this material and we get beautiful results in terms of the incision 99% of the time, as well as in helping the hair follicles that are transplanted flourish. It's no secret that although you can move 100 hairs from the back to the front, for many hair transplant practices, patients can lose up to 50% of those hairs. We've had patients who've come to us from other practices where they've lost practically 100% of the hairs. And it has to do with a lot of factors, including surgical technique and the time the hair follicle is outside of the body, and numerous factors that this is not the necessarily the right time to discuss. However, what you can anticipate now is a waiting period. And a waiting period because it takes at least several months to see significant hair growth when there is this shock loss and dormant period when the hair follicles that have been transplanted are to grow. Hair grows at about a centimeter a month, so allowing some time to let these hairs grow back is pretty much the only choice you have at this point. The medical intervention will probably be helpful to increase the or shorten the period, I should say, where some of these hair follicles start to come back, especially the ones that are being affected by dihydrotestosterone or DHT, such that these hairs will probably flourish and come back based on that concept. So it's an additional thing, information that you've learned hopefully from our discussion, is that there are this new technology that we're employing using extracellular matrix that may be something to consider for the future beyond once your hair transplant has settled in. So basically my advice is to hang in there, continue your communication with your physician, and see how your hair grows and see where you're at approximately in a year. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.